Hello, I'm Yantra Foss and I work for the Athens Institute for Education and Research, which is a world association for academics and researchers. I would like to welcome you to Athener's interview series, where we interview the participants that attend our conference in Athens. Today I'm going to be interviewing Dr. Saif, who is a senior research scientist at the Kuwait Institute for Scientific Research. Hello, welcome to Athens. So, can you give us a brief academic introduction of yourself?
I've been working on issues related to environmental sciences, mostly conducting transport, looking at fate and transport of pollutants and marine environment. That's my interest.
Okay, so tell us about your presentation. What did you present in the conference?
We presented some of the data that we have generated as part of radiological monitoring and radioecology on cesium and plutonium levels in the Arabian Gulf. What are the concentrations of water? Because the region is having a very increased energy demand, and to meet up those demands, they are moving to from fossil fuel burning to better low carbon options. Mm-hmm. One of that is nuclear energy. Mm-hmm. So there is a power plant that has been commissioned in Iran since 2011. It's working. Mm-hmm. There are two power plants that are coming up in UAE. There are 17 that are likely to come up in Saudi Arabia. So our studies were related to what are the basic concentrations, the baseline concentration of radionuclides in the environment, because water is very precious for us. We don't have any freshwater resources in Kuwait. And the entire freshwater demand is met by desalination of CO2. Mm-hmm. So that was the rationale of doing this work.
Okay. So what do you think are the most serious environmental problems in the marine environment of Kuwait?
Marine environment in Kuwait, what we see is the effect of climate change, because we are already in an area where the ecosystem is a bit stressed, in the sense that we have a very extreme temperature. The marine environment is very important for Kuwait, so it needs water demand to meet its full food, which is likely because the dietary habits include seafood component. And then sea is very important for maritime for exports, because about 40% of the oil that is consumed in the world travels through the Arabian Gulf. These are the reasons why marine environment is very important for us. We have been working on different issues related, starting from climate change to contaminant transport within the marine environment, looking at fate and transport of polluting different dry depositions, because Kuwait suffers a lot from dust as well. We do a lot of work on trophic transport, looking at how the biomagnification works in marine environment. So these are some of the issues that we have been currently.
Okay, thank you. So how were you introduced to Athens? You said you've been to our conference before.
Yeah, we have been earlier to this conference. I've attended a couple of times, and it's a regular event. Mm-hmm. It's very, very well planned in a way that we know the dates are fixed, so we can schedule it for quite a long before it happens.
Okay, so tell us a few things about the higher education status, in Kuwait, and what do you think are the advantages and the disadvantages?
Education in Kuwait is a state sponsor. We have Kuwait University, which is the biggest university in the world. Education in Kuwait it has a long history, because in the region, Kuwait was the first one to have very systematic education system. Most of the countries in the Middle East used to depend on Kuwait for their curriculum development. Books were being sent from Kuwait to UAE, Emirates, and everywhere. So we had a very long history of education. Kuwait University is quite a big university where we have about 50% male-female ratio. It deals with all sort of disciplines, from medical sciences to health sciences to sciences and arts. It has a strength of over about 50,000 plus. And then to support that, they have technical colleges which are giving educational, vocational type of training as well. Then we do have some private universities recently. The literacy rate is very high.
Thank you very much.